take your seats. And right on cue, Jeremy Hassan Harnett.
Chairman and Vice Chairman in our county at the
same time. And I would want to bet that. These two people who were elected to lead our party are not your typical party insiders. In fact, Chairman Harnett is a Liberty Caucus favorite. He was elected over a person who was backed strongly by the insiders in Raleigh and Washington, D.C. We're very happy to see him win by a landslide. Woo! Michelle Nitz, a Tea Party favorite, who won by 64% of the vote. Woo-hoo! Another important fact of all this is your Beaufort County delegation voted entirely. Every ballot cast at that convention for Beaufort County was cast for both of these people. This delegation was comprised of people from all arms of the political spectrum in Beaufort County and the Republican Party. The delegation was unanimous. That was absolutely amazing. When is the last time Beaufort County Republicans did something totally together? Give yourself a hand. Best of all is this evening. The brainchild of the Tea Party this evening, we have brought the Republican Party, the Tea Party, and the unaffiliates and nonpartisan, specifically nonpartisan group, and I want to make sure I read this right or say this right, don't turn around cheap, the Better Government Committee here in Beaufort County. Republicans, Tea Party, and the unaffiliates. I was told when I was elected chairman that this could never happen. I disagreed with everybody that said that. Time and again I was told, you're never going to pull this off. And I said, we can if we continue to try. And we did, and it has, and here it is tonight. Thank you. I'm glad you made it here this evening. The evening which proves to be one of those events and when we say, remember when this happened. You're part of history in Beaufort County. You're here this evening to usher in a new era, a new spirit of cooperation, and an event that will surely precipitate with victory in 2016. Thank you all very much. At this time, I'd like to introduce one of the evening's co-sponsors, the chairman of the Beaufort County Patriot Tea Party, Mr. Buzz Caton.
See so many turn out. This is great. Let's let you know that you know how important this coming election is going to be and how important it's going to be to turn this country around. We are the people that can save this country, people like us. The Tea Party has had a bad rap in a lot of places, and it's had a good rap in some good places. And just for 30 seconds, I'd like to tell you about how it started. Some people probably do not know. The Tea Party really started in 2009, so we're not all that old. And the brainchild for the beginning was a fellow named Rick Santelli in Chicago, and he was standing on the floor of the Chicago Board of Trade, and he had a rant and started in on how stupid it is that we're bailing out people that made their own problems in this housing market, and the government is going to come along and spend our money. We're going to have to pay for it. And the rant went on until finally he said, what we need to do is take all these derivatives we've got and go right over here to Lake Michigan and throw them in the lake. And from somebody else jumped up and said, that's the Tea Party. And that's where it came from. And literally from there it started moving across the country. And the cry came up finally that we've been taxed enough already. TEA, the Tea Party. One wonderful thing that happened as these small groups and splinter groups across the country started to come together was the fact that they based it all on the Constitution. If we can get back to the Constitution, we don't have to worry about a lot of other things. That system worked. We perfected the more perfect union. We had a system that was doing fine. We moved forward more in the last 200 years than the world has moved forward in 5,000 years. And it came about because of freedom. It came about by liberty. Care about unalienable rights, life, liberty, pursuit of happiness. And that's what the Tea Party started standing for, still stands for today. You'll notice that a lot of times you'll see the Gadsden flag flying. What that's talking about is don't tread on me. What that really means is government, get out of my life. Leave me alone. The fight that they've had has been very simple. It boils down to about three or four major points. The first thing is we want to protect freedom of religion. We want to protect the unborn. We want to preserve the Second Amendment. We want to guarantee life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That's the basis for what has kept this country free. And that's the thing we've got to continue to work on to keep it free. So our major thrust in the Tea Party has been to educate. We're trying to get the uninformed to finally understand what we're all about. We're trying to get the uninformed that have been misled in your public schools, in your universities, by the television, by the spin that we get, that that is not the way the country needs to go. We don't do rallies anymore. If you'll notice, very few rallies now at the Tea Party. What you're seeing, though, is our presence in the media. You're seeing our presence in email. You're seeing our presence on, believe it or not, we're learning how to use a cell phone. And we're even getting out there, you know, and doing a little bit with texting. We're not a third party, but we are a pressure group, and we're a watchdog. The thing that we have right now, the most important thing that's going for us, and the thing that will keep us alive, is we are not a third party. We are autonomous. This is Washington's Tea Party. Here's a lady here that's chairman of the Tea Party in Greenville, Pitt County. We have another one here that's in Lenoir County. We don't even know what they're doing, except they're doing the same basic things that we're doing. When they can't cut the head off the snake, they can't kill us. And we are way ahead of them for that very reason. But what we do represent are the culture and the needs of the immediate people around us. And that's what makes it so great that we can take this message forward, hopefully, deliver this, and get enough people on our side that next time around we don't make the mistake that we made and people stay home. We've got to get like-minded people that believe like we believe out to vote. I'm not only interested in encouraging those folks to vote the other way. I want those who vote like us. Thank you so much for being here, and thank you for allowing me a minute to talk to you.
Also a co-sponsor in this evening's event is the, well, I got to cheat again, I always mess this up, the Better Government Committee, the chairman of that, Harold Smith. Harold, where are you?
You still got it wrong.
I still got it wrong.
Three citizens for Better Government.
Citizens for Better Government.
Folks, I don't talk nearly as much as Keith and Bud said. Thank you for being here. We are the citizens of Better Government in Berkeley County. But you are also a watchdog and a pressure group locally. We thank you for being here. We are pleased to be a co-sponsor of tonight's event. A special thank you to Michelle and Hassan. Welcome to Washington.
And this time I was supposed to introduce elected officials, but I haven't seen. Well, I see Terry. Terry Williams, Board of Education. Terry, take a bow. Commissioner Hood Richardson is here to see you. Any other elected officials?
Mike Isbell.
Oh, Mike Isbell. Mike, how you doing? Take a bow. And anyone else? All right. People running for office, I know Philip Law running for Congress.
Correct, sir.
Philip Law. Kirk Jenkins running for Chocolatey Town Council. Anybody else running for office?
Mayor.
Ah, Latoya. Running for?
Mayor
of Fulton Court, sir. Very good. Welcome to all of you. A lot of people come up when they're getting ready to introduce somebody and tell you everything they know about them. I don't know a whole lot about Michelle and Hassan. I know what I've seen, I know what I've read. When it came time to vote for somebody for the chairman of the Beaufort County Republican Party, I knew who I didn't want, but I really didn't know who I did want until I started doing my homework. Michelle I knew. Michelle I've run into at many third district meetings. We fought in the trenches together from time to time. I know she's been very active, absolute firebrand in the Republican Party. She did the same thing I did, decided I've had it, I'm not taking it anymore, I'm going to get involved and make a difference, and by God, she is. So thank you for that. When I asked Michelle if she would consider coming out here this evening and speak to the chairman and ask him if he'd be willing to come, there was no hesitation whatsoever. They wanted to come here to Beaufort County, meet the good citizens here, and see what they could do to make a difference in the future of Beaufort County, North Carolina, and the United States of America. Hassan Harnett, our chairman, I'm just simply amazed by this man. First of all, he's always smiling. I don't know how he does that. I know as county chairman is hard. I can't imagine his job. So how he always smiles is just amazing to me. But this guy had me from the first time I spoke to him on the phone. You could tell he was sincere. I looked him up. I looked at his family. Is he pro-life? How many children? Three children? So, you know, that kind of tells me he's pro-life, so I was good with that. I spoke to him on issues dealing with the Second Amendment. Of course, that's near and dear to my heart. Did a little homework on him. He's not the Republican Party as usual. He's not that half-baked, going to do a half job. He's the person that's going to get out there, do the job, attack it with absolute ferocity, and get it done. He is from the Liberty Caucus, endorsed by Liberty Caucus. What can go wrong with that? He's going to help us unite this party. He's going to change the attitude of politics from top down. We're going to get our own rule back. That's the way it should be. I've read these things about him. I know what he stands for, and I know he'll continue on that path as our party chairman. And most importantly, Michelle Nix and Hassan Harnett are going to do the absolute most important job that needs to be done, and that is to bring us victory in 2016 and throw the bums out of our White House. Vice Chairman Michelle Nix. Give him a warm up.
One word simply describes how I feel right now, and that word is wow.